Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be cash stuffing for week 3 of March. And today also marks 1 year since I posted my very first YouTube video. I can't believe it's been a whole year since I started doing this method. Intentionally, I'd started it at the start of 2022, but not properly. And honestly, it's completely changed my outlook. I said that in my last video. I'm not going to repeat myself. Well, I just did. But no, I just wanted to thank every single person who has supported my channel. If you'd said to me a year ago that I would have this many subscribers, that I would have an Etsy shop where I sell binders. I've got a few here actually. These are going to go out soon. So this is a 2K candy floss edition. This is the betrothal binder. It's going to be coming out in 4K because this customer wanted it in 4K. And this is the thistle edition. And I do a lot of other designs as well. Yeah, so if you told me I'd have an Etsy shop where I sell binders and placeholders, yeah, I wouldn't believe you, but here we are. So 1 year on YouTube, massive thank you. But let's get on with the cash stuffing. I'm going to try and make this video a bit shorter than the last one. So today I am going to be cash stuffing £360. So I have 50 and 100, and then 20, 40, 60, 80, 200, 20, 40, 60, 260, 270, 80, 90, 300, 310, 320, 30, 40, 345, 55, and 60. So £360, I hope you're all doing very well. We're gonna first of all see what I have left over from the last week. This is starting to look really grubby. I need to get some pink stuff on it or something. Right, what have I got left in coins? So, I have 1, 2, 3 pounds in pound coins. And then I've got one. Oh, look, finally I've got Charlie. I was in the post office and I was buying some sellotape and it was 1.50. And I was like, have you got any 50 pences for the change, the new ones? And she did. So that's the new King Charles III. I did get a question asking about our money since the Queen passed away. So basically the Royal Mint have released this one, which is the Charles 50 pence, and slowly they'll release others and the others will just go out of circulation. So this is the front and then the back basically looks like that. So it's got the three lions, the harp. Yeah, three lions and a harp, and it's 2022 minted. So I'm not going to put that in my challenges. I'm going to put that to one side. And then the notes, Bank of England have released the designs of the new notes with Charles on the front. And I think over time they'll just release them and the rest will go out of circulation. It'll probably take a few years, to be honest. So anyway, 50s that I will stuff. Oh, what's that one? That's Sir Isaac Newton. I don't think I've got that one actually. Right, I might keep that one as well. And then I've got 150 and another 50 and some change. Okay, groceries has nothing, fuel has nothing, spending's got 5. I'll probably put that towards my nights out rather than the £5 challenge. I have some money to go back to the bank, and then I've got 3 5s to go to the £5 challenge. Right, okay, so let's restuff this now for the next week. So groceries is first of all going to get £50, so 20, 40 and 50. Fuel is going to get £20, and then spending is as usual going to get 35. And then I do this infinity challenge, so I roll this dice and whatever I land on, I'll save towards a sinking fund later on. Okay, so last time I was on this 20, so let's see what we get. Oh, you can't see that, but it's a 0, which means I stay where I am. Damn it, I should have rolled again because you couldn't see it. Never mind. Right, so 20 is going to go towards a sinking fund. which means I have £15 for spending for the next week. I don't think I've got much on. It's Mother's Day on Monday, on Sunday, which I've got presents for. Yeah, and I don't think I'm doing much else. Right, okay, let's move on. So next up we have my variable binder. These resin binders are from Little Carousel Gifts on Etsy. I did get a question asking if I'm releasing them. No, I don't make these. The link should be in the description of the video. Right, so we're starting with Hair and Beauty. And Hair and Beauty is today going to get £20. So I now have 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 20 and 30. I still need to buy shampoo, so I need to do that quite soon. Clothes is today going to get £10. So we now have 20, 40, 60, 80, 90, 95 and 100 in clothes. Nights out is going to get £5 plus the £5 I had from spending. So I've now got 5, 10 and 15. And next up, I've made a new envelope for yoga. Are you ready? This is my new yoga envelope. I don't know if you can see it very well. But I used to do Kundalini yoga quite a lot. And basically it's all about the 7 chakras. So you've got the root. Oh, I don't know what they all are. Crown, throat, head, chest, navel. Oh, something, navel, I don't know. Anyway, such good yoga, but it's quite intense actually for yoga. Anyway, so this is my new yoga envelope. If you didn't see my last video, I'm gonna start going back to hot yoga. And I'd probably need to save about 40 quid a month for it. So today yoga's gonna get £10. So I've now got 20. If you like this envelope, I won't be selling it. I don't want to do envelopes. There's loads of people out there who do individual envelopes, and this one was so finicky and time consuming. So it's just for me, sorry, if you like it. Right, books is not getting anything, but we've got 35. Home is gonna get £10. So I have 50, 100, 110, 120, and 130. In home. Garden is getting skipped. It's got 25. No, it's not. It's got 35. And gifts is getting skipped and it's got 15. Okay, so that's it for the variable binder. So now moving on to birthdays. Let's just see what I've got for Bellatrix. 20, 30, 40. I'm going to add another 20. So I've got 20, 40, 50 and 60, and that should be her done. So that's it for that one. And then next we will move into my sinking funds. Okay, so we're starting with insurance. Now then, insurance is gonna get £10. So in insurance, I've got 250 in the bank and then 270, 280, 90, 300, 310. I got a comment saying that their car insurance hadn't gone up, so fingers crossed it won't go up, but we'll see. All right, so that's insurance done. Next up, we've got car tax, and car tax is going to get £5. So I now have 20, 25, and 30 in car tax. So I can colour in another car. All right, car maintenance is getting skipped. Kingston is going to get £5. So I now have 20, 25 and 30. And I can colour in very badly another lawnmower. Home maintenance and appliances is getting skipped. I try and stuff that in my side hustle. I did film a side hustle and post it a couple of days ago. Okay, my holiday fund is gonna get £100. So 50 and 100. So I now have 250 in the bank and then 300, 350, 455, 550, 570, 590, 610, excuse me, 630 and 650. That should be enough now to book my flights. So I'm gonna, it's Saturday tomorrow and I need to spend some time doing that. I got a couple of comments about me using my browser and perhaps that's why the cost has gone up. I was aware of that. So actually what I did when I first looked at the flights, I looked on Skyscanner and then I set up a price alert and I just get an email when the price changes. So I haven't actually gone in and searched myself. And I was actually under the impression, because I'm sure there was a Panorama investigation a while ago, that they weren't allowed to use cookies anymore to increase prices. But I don't think they legislated against it. I just think they said to companies that wasn't exactly moral. Whether they took any notice or not, who knows? But yeah, anyway, I'll book my flights and I need to book an extra night because the flight gets in too late to start the next day. But I'll do that soon. So 650 in holiday fund. Can I tick off another one of these? Yeah, I can tick off another one of these. So I shall do that. This travel treasury was gifted to me by Esther from My Money Matters and I love it. So that's that. And then trip fund is getting skipped this week. So that's it for my variable binder. Okay, moving on to Christmas baubles. So if you watched my last video, I unstuffed some of this because I bought some tickets for my sisters for Christmas. So we're behind where we were, but we're trying to get back up there. So today, what's it getting? Right, £10. So let's tick off. Sorry about the ring light. It's just a bit late. Oh, I might just put a little video in here. Before, when I was finishing work, I looked out the window and there was this most remarkable rainbow, double rainbow. Absolutely stunning, but this is a prime example of how our weather doesn't know what to do. But I thought it was beautiful, so I took a quick video. So anyway, £10, so let's find the next 10. There we go. If you do struggle to get binders from me, I was looking on Etsy the other day and there's quite a few sellers now who sell things like really similar. So I'm not knocking it at all. I think it's great. So please like have a look. And there's other people who sell stuff like this. So if you can't get one, have a look about. Okay, so that's it for Christmas. Okay, so now moving on to my savings challenges. This is looking a bit manky. I need to clean this. Okay. Starting with rainy day. So rainy day is going to get £20. So I now have 500, 700, 800 pounds in the bank, and then 820, 840, 860. We're getting close. I don't even know how much an iPhone is. The 14 out. I don't even know how much they are. Like, I've got no idea. I should really have a look at it because it's probably more than a grand, isn't it? Because I'll want a bigger storage capacity. So anyway, right. Next up is energy. And energy is going to get £20. So I now have 250 in the bank and then 270, 290, 300, 310, 315 and 320 in energy. So I can cross off a 20. It's definitely been warmer today. I felt it before I went to the post office and I could actually feel the sun, like as in the warmth of it on us, which was lovely. Okay, and it's getting lighter in the morning, isn't it? You can just feel it. It's coming. I mean, I'm talking for those in the Northern Hemisphere, sorry. Okay, quarter one is this week. It's week 11. Here, which is £10. So I've now got 200 in the bank and then 220, 40, 50, 65. 265, so we can colour in week 11, which means we've only got two left. Oh God, that was horrible. Right. two left, and then I think an extra 10 or 20 quid, and I can buy the ring that I want. Come on. Okay. So that's quarter one. Oh, Gordon Bennett, get in, man. Okay. Build a buffer and sparks of joy are trying stuff inside Hustle, so they're getting skipped. Okay, next roll with it. So this £20, let's see where it's gonna go this week. Where do I want it to go? Let's have a think. Christmas would be good to try and boost that back up. Or, yeah. Nights out would be good. Seven. Oh, Christmas, yay! You manifest? Well, I didn't really manifest, did I? Okay. Oh, sorry, Errol. Jeez. I'm really sorry about that. I hope you haven't got concussion. Okay, £20 then. So let's go back and do this 20 here at the top. Where is the 20? There it is. Good, I'm happy about that. Okay, so that is that done with Roll With It. Esther from My Money Matters has released a Roll With It challenge. I don't know if you've seen it, and I don't know if I've mentioned it. I might have. So I think it's a six-sided dice, and it's blank, so you can just write in with a Sharpie what you want your categories to be. So go and check her out. Right. Oh, sorry. Far too zoomed in. Okay, next up we've got my £5 challenge, which is gonna get these three fives from my shopping. Shall we see how we're looking? I'm not gonna count it till the end of the year. This is how we are looking, which is great. Does anybody watch Intentional Living? In the US, her $1 challenge is already like this big. Oh, it's great. Okay, next up we've got Budget with Ira. All right then, so Budget with Ira. So we have, it was three, wasn't it? One, two, and £3, which I'm happy with because I know what we're doing and I can't be bothered. And it's putting sprinkles on donuts. I'm not dissing you, Ira, I'm sorry. It's a great challenge, but this one just takes a while. So what I've said is every five sprinkles is worth £1. So we'll do 15 sprinkles. So just, you know, make yourself a cup of tea, get a glass of wine, one, two, five. Woo! Okay. So, £3 is going into Budget with Ira. Fabulous. All right, so that's Budget with Ira done. And then 50p's. So I've got 2 50p's after my taking out the others. So let's pop them in here. I can definitely condense that at the end of the month, I think, which is good. So let's colour in 2 50s. So we've only got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 left, and then we'll have done this once. And then I will do it again. I'll just like mark that I've done it once somehow. Okay. And then finally, we have the penny challenge. I don't think I need my calculator, so I've got 20, 30, 40. Oh no. I have to start again. 10, 30, 40, 60, 72, 74, 76, 77, 77, 77, 77. Sorry about before, Errol. I hope you're okay. 77. Okay, so I can do, I can't, I think. Right, I can do a 70 and then I've got 7 left. So let's do a 5 and a 2. It's gonna get harder, isn't it, as I lose the lower numbers, but you know, that's cool. There we go. So that's a penny challenge done again for another week. And that is the end of today's cash stuffing. Thank you so much for being here. And again, thank you for supporting my channel for a whole year. I hope that this is the first of many years to come, because I can't see me ever falling out with this. It's changed my outlook completely. And if you're out there watching and thinking that you want to try this, just do it. Honestly, just do it. Even if you budget with a piece of paper and you've got, you know, some envelopes that you'd use to post letters or whatever it is, just start it, because it definitely changes how you perceive finances and, you know, what you're spending your money on, I would say. Yeah, listen, thank you for watching. Please leave me a comment, please leave me a like, and subscribe if you enjoy, and I shall see you in my next cash stuffing. Thanks guys, bye. Thank you.